Hey team, Justin with ManageByStats. In this video, we're going to be covering the advanced section in SellerMail. Let's get right to it. All right, let's click on Show Advanced. Now we've already covered up here, if you want to send this email to specific ASINs or SKUs, you would add them here. Conversely, if you don't want to send it to specific ASINs or SKUs, you would add those here. The next section is a repeat buyer type. So the default option is ignored, but you can send this email out to anyone who has purchased any product, selected products, or if you're sending out to multiple products and you want to exclude some, you would choose this option here. So let me just show you what options you get if you choose selected SKUs. This gives you the option to send out targeted emails to repeat buyers. Now for an example, let's say you wanted to send out a coupon to someone who has purchased your product for a third time. This is where you would choose that option. So your next two options are spent more than and spent less than. Let's say you're doing a coupon to encourage reviews. Now, you're not asking for 5-star reviews, because that would be naughty. You have a $10 product, you're giving $9 off. The next email in the flow might be a 50% off coupon. Now, you may not want to send that email out to the people you just gave 90% off to. So, you would then use the spent more than and just put it over $2 or something like that. LTV stands for lifetime value. You might use this section for people who have spent more than $100 and you want to give them a one-time 50% off or 75% off coupon. That would be a perfect example of when you would use this section. The next one is order number ends with. This is something that you would use for split testing. So order ends with 2468 or 1359, and you have two different emails that you set up for each. That's what this is good for. The limit to section, I actually recommend that you leave as default, which is one email per SKU per shipment. Basically what that means is that if they order three of one product in one order, they're not then going to get three emails. Now to give you an idea of some of the other options, let's just say for instance, rather than sending out one email per SKU per shipment, you just wanted one email per shipment. You could choose that right here. Now let's say you set this up as a refund email. You of course don't want it to be the default status, which is ignored. So you would either set it to no refunds ever, no refund on this order, got a refund on this order, or has gotten a refund on a past order. Feedback status. Now keep in mind, this is not a product review. This is a review on you as a seller in Seller Central. And these are your options here. Moving on to attachments. You have an 8 MB max limit. Now that doesn't sound like a lot of space, but you don't want to be putting large attachments in there anyhow. Usually it's an instructional PDF. And if you think of anything else it could be, let me know, because I don't know what else you would attach there. Next up is coupon codes. Now this is something you do inside of Seller Central. You set up your coupons, one-time use coupons, and then you can upload that CSV here. And then for every email that gets sent out, you get one coupon code per email. That's all. Like this video and subscribe and hit the bell icon so that when we put up new content, you'll be notified. See you in the next one.